Assalamu alaikum, umjambo, hello, and welcome to a post-colonization America. My name is Nova Usa, and I will be your guide on this new endeavor, hopefully ending corruption forever. We understand that this may be a trying time for your mind, but that's a sign that you're growing. With no divine repercussions, come see. Take this apple off the tree on your journey to knowing where you fit in, where you've been, and where you fought to be or not to be. We ask you to please kick back, relax, and again, follow me. We've gotten suggestions to change the recipe to Aunt Ethel's soup, to become a people of more power than powder, sustenance with more substance. With your input, we have handcrafted a future. Based on results and strategies of previous models, we have developed a top-of-the-line program that will allow for our harmony and self-sufficiency. Spoiler alert, we will be okay.
Well, this is going south. My response is to dip out. I'm been ready, so there's no need to get ready. You can call me Noah because I've secured the ark. I got this bag of goods that everyone overlooked, but this is a call to my people. My services need to be booked. While they mocked my preparation, I proceeded to move towards separation. Collected every gem neglected. Onions, garlic, thyme, and sage. Sulfuric chemical reactions to burn the bodies of devils. Become medicinal regulation for blood pressure and sugar levels. My people, it's time to counteract the natural bacteria that ills our very existence and restore our mental cognition. These neutral bullets be my weapons of warfare. Create toxins to defend and potions for care. Even at the lowest of concentrations, my devices can shock your system and leave no amounts of tracing. They said I was crazy, bugging to be exact, that herbs and spices couldn't be a saving grace, that my efforts were lazy, and that this was an attempt to save face. Just watch when it's all said and done. This kitchen is hot, and I've only just begun. I'm fighting for the revolution. My word is bond. They look concerned. Who's bugging now?
African kings, queens, doctors, farmers, and laborers alike all roam the earth with confidence, style, and grace, with pride in their culture swelling in their hearts. They love themselves, their culture, and every aspect of their blackness, perpetually and passionately. But as the Europeans came talking about colonization, stuffing them into boats, saying America's the destination, their strength and their faith started wavering. Slowly but surely, one by one, stripped away was the confidence, the style, the grace. But don't get it twisted. Not everyone was reduced to docile beings, only able to utter yes, sir, and no, ma'am, just happily playing their roles as mammies and Aunt Jemimas. Harriet Tubman followed the drinking gourd more than 20 times and led over 300 brothers and sisters to freedom. Gabriel Prosser attempted to take possession of Capitol Square in Richmond, where he tried to hold the governor as his hostage. Nat Turner's rebellion in Virginia, Charles Deslandes in the German Coast Uprising, Denmark Vesey's planned revolt in South Carolina, all individuals brave enough to stand up to the oppressor and lead our people in rebellion. Abe Lincoln set us free. And by set us free, I mean he passed Jim Crow the keys to our shackles, pushing us to the back of buses, removing our men from our homes, denying us assistance if we maintained our family structures, lynching our men, degrading our women, horrifying our children. Don't forget what they did to Emmett Till. He was beaten beyond recognition, shot in the head, and tossed in the Tallahatchie River. One of many examples of your fate if you chose to be anything but complacent. But as the heroes rose before, they rose again. Martin Luther King Jr. and his peaceful protest, Malcolm X and his by any means necessary attitude, Claudette Colvin, the Rosa Parks before Rosa Parks was Rosa Parks. Time and time again, pink people have fought to suppress and deny our beauty, strength, and power. Trying to convince us that black lives don't matter but blue ones do, that my kinky coils and wide nose aren't beautiful because they don't align with European standards. But guess what? The days of me eating every live plate on the plate in front of me are over. I'm saying goodbye to complacency and saying what's good to loving myself audaciously. Pink people uprooted us and planted us in the concrete in 1619, denied us the things we needed to grow, and waited for us to wilt. In 2018, they still trying to figure out how from the concrete, a beautiful rose, black and proud, was ever able to bloom.
She ran through numbers faster than Uzis run through bullets. Her mind was a mind beam, booming with brilliance, brighter than a firecracker and a bona fide black badass. So smart. until everything went black. But by the time they got things up and running, government secrets were good as gone. And it happened again and again and again, but only when acts of terror were committed across the nation. Orlando gunman kills 49 people, blackout. Las Vegas shooters raise gunfire on a crowd, blackout. 17 dead in school shooting in Parkland, Florida, blackout. While bullets ripped through innocent skin and rifles rang like school bells, saying the thief made off without a trace. No one knew why, no one knew how. But I guess the CIA would have to find out.
Why? Think about everything you do in a day. Ask yourself, if we had no access to water, to Maji, how would we live? Ask yourself, if we had no access to water, to Maji, how would we live?
When I think about the Nile River and what it's done for me, when I think about water and how it set me free, I just can't see Gail scream. Ah! Water! When I think about the Nile River and what didn't try. try to alter water's course, we follow it. Let it lead us to the promised land. We used to work with water, know how to use water properly to replenish our water-depleting bodies. Yeah, back then, water was sacred. Water was everything to and for us. Us, who are made up of 55 to 65% water, about 83% running through our blood, almost 75% making up our brain and heart, 70% found in our muscles, 31% in the average human body's bones. Us warm-blooded beings knew that water was the element from which all beings came and returned. This was what we knew about water in relation to ourselves. But how drastically things have changed.
We can't live without Target. Yes, we can.
we can. Chicago, Detroit, Flint, Boston, Baltimore, North Dakota, and Trenton are some places plagued by water contamination. Lead levels higher than you could ever imagine. Brown, red, green, orange, black colors. Residents see coming from their faucets due to our disconnect to water. How does this happen? Our water control system comes from iron pipes dating back to the 19th century to most recently plastic pipes beginning in the 1970s. Our water control system is old, white-owned, and strategically placed. Low-income neighborhoods suffer the most, which we know oftentimes means black people are suffering the most. Why should anyone be subject to poison when death, brain deterioration, and mental instability are the end result, unless that was their plan in the first place? Today, we have forgotten about the power of water. But if we took back the world today, the first thing I would do is begin a plan that helps undo all of our current water control systems, a plan that resembles the protesters in Canada, Brazil, the Philippines, a plan that resembles our first natives' waves, while simultaneously implementing new plans that don't disturb nature. Call it water governance, water sustainability, water protection, holistic water management, whatever you call it, just make sure water is revered. The big hidden secret to improving a society is recognizing the environment we live in and learning to work with it. Today, I declare among the people ready to be free, ready to be healthy, ready to be one with Mother Earth, that my decolonized mind is one with the universe, not against it. I will no longer remain silent about the misuse and neglect of water. I will educate my brothers and sisters. I will create new plans that help our nation.
Did we lose our ability to learn, our talent, our heritage? Did we lose our capacity for independence, making us dependent on our dependents?
Are we lost, like the Israelites in the desert after Kemet?
Or are we struggling with everything we've been given?
You've killed our brothers and shamed our sisters. In order for us to reach success, we've submitted to your oppression. When we try to come up, we're beat back down with your words, your fists, your guns, and your power. You've scared us into a place of complacency, and we can't imagine life any other way.
Have you ever seen a child with no fear? A child leaning over the 16-story balcony, or reaching out to pet a pit bull? A child wandering away from her mother, into the street, with all the cars she's not concerned about? It can't even be called bravery. She doesn't know what to be scared of. As time goes on, she sure does learn. Fear is the fuel feeding coercion, the force filter that keeps any alternative mindset at bay, the levees that hold us, the real us, back, but without breaking. There is a crack, and when something slips through, bullets are sprayed, examples are made, and those mindsets fade.
We forgot the ingredients to freedom, the seasonings of knowing ourselves. Our dough has been beaten instead of carefully kneaded, and that special something? Taken out. It lies within us, as the recipe lies in their hands.
Segregation provided the ingredients for hatred in the so-called melting pot. A few handfuls of school inequality, enough racial slurs to fill an ocean, and God knows how many lynchings.
Stir in forced integration and watch the already simmering hatred intensify to a rolling boil. Stir in affirmative action and watch the pot boil over, which gave pink people a reason to complain because it's such a shame that my people were now on equal footing with them. But none of it helped. None of it was meant to help because all that Jim Crow stuff wasn't just laws. It was a mentality, and no piece of legislation can overrule that.
You watch every move we make, waiting for us to mess up, so you can come and serve justice. You tricked us into believing you were really here for us. In reality, you were breaking us so that you could control us.
The only purpose it served was to make me feel like they actually cared, knowing that they didn't, so that they could continue to mess me over, knowing I was too hypnotized to ask any questions.
And when we attempted to break free of your grip, each time, you found a new way to shut us back down. And we took it because we didn't want to be dead, missing, or whatever nonsense you could envision.
Now, I might sound crazy or paranoid. These thoughts are often belittled as conspiracy theories. But understand that J. Edgar Hoover invented that phrase, the man that ran the organization, that targeted the Black Panthers, and the whole civil rights movement. If I could look Hoover in the face, I would want to say,
go and tell your COINTELPRO, come at me. But
fear, complacency, that's what they wanted.
And that's exactly what we gave them.
Self-sufficiency or socialism? This has been one of our frequently asked questions, so let me give you the facts. Turn that me into a we is a way of life that worked for our ancestors for generations. Try to think back to a time in history where someone only caring about themselves advance the people, accomplish the common goal, put food on everyone's table. Now let me clarify, this does not mean don't care for yourself, always put the needs of others before your own. What it does mean is operate using a community mindset, realizing the validity of the old proverb, I am because we are, and since we are, therefore I am. And working together, give to give, get to get.
Hitman!
reality. If we keep ignoring our dependence on water, by 2030, half of our world population will suffer. We need to start investing in tools like the desalinator, tools that help desalinate water. Because without these tools, we have no water. And without water, we have no life. Directly linked to the beginnings of life, shaping the world, serving as a path through the human passage of life, symbolizing purification, its manifestation mentally, physically, emotionally, spiritually, personifies change, growth, from the sky to the air, the oceans, the ground, on our bodies, in our bodies, our mouths, our eyes. Water saves lives, takes lives, creates lives, and keeps the circle of life in motion. Without water, there is no humanity. There is no joint lubrication, no nourished brain. There is no earth without water. Water. Maji. Water. Maji. Water. Maji. Water. Maji. Water. Maji. Water. Maji. We come with water. We live with water. We survive with water. We grow with water. We flourish with water. We move with water. We need water. We need water. We need water. If we want to be free, we must wade in the water. Wade in the water. Wade in the water. Breathe in the water. Save our water. Protect our water. Go back to our native ways and worship water. Work with water. Protect water. Give thanks to our water gods, Yemiya, Oshun, and reclaim that water is life. Because contrary to popular belief, we can live without a lot of things, but we cannot live without water.
Spirituality, a belief system that many before us and even some now live by, dictated that knowing your ancestors was the same as knowing yourself. In fact, if you didn't know your family line 7 generations back, you didn't know yourself. Knowledge of self, and therefore our strength, was stripped away as we were force-fed that mush on those ships. Freedom can simply be the ability to know. The ability to have a vault the size of Africa, stocked with power, made of the same material as the contents of Tutankhamun's tomb, with no room for emptiness. We want to overflow with free as bleed drips from our lips, as stories of ourselves and our ancestors caress our children's ears and our culture pleases their eyes. Takes them by the hands and leads them into a future where they can say, truthfully, free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty, we are free at last.
Was when our dependence exploded. excluded us.
Our black dependence today sounds like a refusal to admit that the so-called white people food is really just the food we used to ingest, of course with more seasons and flavors, from when we were the farmers, the landowners, the gardeners, the ones connected to the heavens, the earth, and the people.
I'll call when we have a community, but only if it looks right.
If we depended on each other, community gardens would be everywhere. I'm talking about the sweetest, juiciest, freshest, vitamin-packed
apples, pineapples, berries, spinach,
carrots, mushrooms, picked on our own lands, shared with our own hands. This is how it could, should, and would be.
We would be actors, writers, directors, producers, technicians. We would use black girl magic and make black TV magicians. And we would watch seasons of us in hijinks and wacky situations, fancy black aristocrats giving fancy black salutations.
We can redefine development, depending on each other every time we need food, anytime we need shelter, every time we need water. Consumer resources provided
by us, for us, near us. Our ancestors were stripped of their resources, forced to make do with the scraps, the leftovers, and every unhealthy food you could think of. And as time passed, we couldn't remember our ancestors' ways. Instead, we kept those low-down practices, limiting ourselves to greasy pots, pans, and white sugar death sentences.
But if black people depended on black people, we would have some good TV.
We could collectively sustain our own lives.
We would realize that our consumerism habits today are not ours, because the power of commerce lies in their hands. They determine the who, what, when, where, why, and hows of the industry.
But if we depended on each other, we could put down their whitewash remote and support members of our empire. We could stop selling our stories to the top bidding buyer. We could use our resources to get stories straight from the supplier. We would have black science fiction and social black nerds, black actors acting out historic black words.
Me and those who look like we make up a force, stronger than any self-help, self-doubt, self-hate, blame-shifting mindset, working to avoid the unknown.
We would understand the importance of being educated by our own brothers and sisters in agriculture, and know that the road to freedom is not an easy one,
but it is possible.
That simple foundation looks like nostalgia, smells like fresh gardens, tastes like natural healing.
Our new and improved version of finger-licking good food would be true soul food, because we would value our lives, our spirits, ensuring that our minds, bodies, and souls are replenished.
Us intelligent beings of the earth won't start living until we take
black the world. We would finally tell the truth about what we really need to live. We need food, shelter, water, and love. And this can only happen
if we depend on we.
Than waking up to the scent of sizzling bacon and sweet pancakes made by your mother's loving hands. Nothing more exciting than anxiously awaiting the arrival of your father so you can tell him all your accomplishments and see his big gleaming smile as he tells you, "I'm so proud of you." Nothing compares to those long weekend nights spent with your cousins or the everlasting Sundays that consist of church, and even more church. Weekdays consist of school and tending to the land. We learn English and arithmetic through the beauty of agriculture and the art of nature. You see nature as a gift that must be nurtured and cared for, learning to caress the soil with tender touches, giving back more well-being of the family, the true life skills that ensure longevity. We build community through community. With our families within arm's reach, our elders are able to offer a library of experience, raising legacies built off values, morals, and traditions from long ago. The home is a biodegradable safe haven, built to last a century, made of straw bales stronger and more powerful than any artificial material. But it is more than just the straw bale between the walls. It is strong in love and structure. We bring each other up so we won't fall down, and our support surpasses the walls of the home. We go into your minds and pockets. We refuse to ignore the inner workings of your brain. And our money is being recycled back to us, buying black to stay black, building a support system that continuously grows and stands tall against any storm. Beautifully crafted with love, growth, and strength, a home is more than just a house, and a family is more than just two kids and a spouse.
Thank you. change your life. Those cookies and punch, BCC Punch, is open and available to you. Thank you to all of you for coming out, parents, friends, family, all of y'all. Oh, stop. Thank you all for your being here. Get to know somebody today. Love on each other. And let's take back this world, y'all. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you.